We are discussing about a binomial theorem. In a binomial expansion, what is a general term? What is the middle term? How we are going to find out? So if we have x plus a to the power n, and if we do the binomial expansion, it will be nc0, x to the power n, e to the power 0. And nc1, x to the power n minus 1, a to the power 1. So this goes up to ncn, x to the power 0, a to the power n. Now what is the first term here? The first term is nc0, x to the power n, a to the power 0. What is the second term? Nc1, x to the power n minus 1, a to the power 1. Now, can you see some pattern here? Now, the subscript of C, if it is 1 left hand side, it is 0 here. That is 1 more than, the left hand side is 1 more than right hand side. If it is 2, if the second term 2, it is 1 more than the subscript of C, that is 1. So, if you have T, R plus 1, any R plus 1 is NCR, x to the power n minus r and a to the power r. Now this is, I want you to check it. So because it is, if it is r, if nc1, if it is r, r is 1, then it should be r plus 1, that is 2. So tr plus 1 is ncr, x to the power n minus r, a to the power r. This is the general term, tr plus 1 term. If you have x minus a to the power n, then what will be the general term? So you have to just put a as minus a. So it will be tr plus 1 term. What will be the general term of this binomial expansion? It will be minus 1 to the power r. Everything remains same. Ncr, x to the power n minus r, and a to the power r. Now when we come to 1 plus x to the power n, then you want to find out the general term or tr plus 1. So it will be ncr, x to the power r. Now if you want to have a tr plus 1 for 1 minus x to the power n, then what is the r plus 1th term? Minus 1 to the power r. Next thing remains same, ncr, x to the power r. So in a binomial expansion, see, if you know the, you remember the Pascal triangle. So the first number is the last number. The second number is the second last number. So if you start from the front and start from the rear, if you go similar steps, you will find the same number, same coefficients. Okay? Same coefficients. You have seen this in Pascal triangle also. So what is the rth term from the end? It will be n plus 1 minus r plus 1. It will be n plus 1 minus r plus 1. Any rth term means in between some term, when you start from the rear, it will be n minus r plus 2. You will learn it more when we actually go to the problems. So any term from the rear you can find out using n minus r plus 2. So if you want to find out the middle term, if n is, if, see, every x plus a to the power n has n plus 1 term. How many terms are there in x plus a to the power 1? How many terms are there? See, n plus 1, you do it, n plus 1. It is 1 plus 1. So two terms are there, x and a. Now, I'll give you an example of x plus a whole square also. It will be x square plus 2ax plus a square. How many terms are there? If it is 2, the index is 2. You have three terms here, x square, 2ax and x a square. So n plus 1 terms are there. For every binomial expression of n, the terms will be n plus 1. Always remember, expansion will have n plus 1 term. So if n is even, now we are trying to find out the middle term. So if n is even, then the middle term will be n by 2 plus 1. The middle term, since n is even, and you will get how many terms? N plus 1, that is odd terms you will get. So it will be center one. You will get an odd term. But if n is odd, what will happen when it is odd? It will be the Banu expansion will be odd plus 1, that is n plus 1. So you will have even term. So you will have 2 in between. N plus 1 by 2 and this is n plus 1 together. And then n plus 3 by 2. These are the two terms in between if n is odd. So this is how you are going to find out the middle term. Now I will try to take all the flavors of different type of questions which arises. Different type of questions that can be formed, and we will try to see the NCERT questions. So now we need to find out the general term or an indicated term in the binomial expansion of some given expression. So this is a question, x square minus y to the power 6. Now we want to find out the general term. This is an NCERT question. We want to general term. So tr plus 1 is what? You know tr plus 1 is what? NCR x to the power n minus r a to the power r. This we already seen. So what is n here? The index is n. It is 6. Now you can write this x square as x square minus y as x square plus minus y to the power 6. Just to make it easier. You can make it easier. So tr plus 1 is what? You know it is NCR. N is 6 here. So 6CR. Then x is what? X square. X square to the power n minus r. That is 6 minus r. That is 6 minus r. And what is y here? Minus y square. Minus y square. And what is the power r? So this is the general term. If you want to, you know, take this minus 1 out, minus 1 to the power will be there, 6CR. X to the power, multiply this 6 minus 2 by 2. So it will be 12 minus 2R. And y to the power r. This is the general term. This is how we are going to find out the general term of any expansion. So if you want to general term, you have to find tr plus 1 term, not tr. You have to find tr plus 1. Now let us take one more. Now you have to find out the 13th term in the expansion of 13th term. We are taking specific number now. In nx, 9x minus 1 by 3 root t, root x to the power 18. Now, we would like to find out the 30th term, terwa, 13th term. So, t13 we have to find out. But t13 can only be written when it is valid t12 plus 1. t13 is t12 plus 1. Right? So, what is the NCR? 18CR, what is the R? What is R? This 12 you have to take. Don't take 13. Always take tr plus 1. So, this is 12. And what is the first term? 9x. 9x to the power what? 18. That is to the power 18 minus r. 18 minus 12. And this is minus 1 by 3 root x. This is minus 1 by 3 root x. And to the power, what will be the power? 12. That is r. So, you need to just, you know, solve it. The t13 term will come. And I'll just give you some idea here. 18c12, let it be like this. 9 to the power, no, 18 minus 12 is 6. So it will be 9 to the power 6. It will be 9 to the power 6. So write it as 9 to the power 6. Then you have x to the power 6. And how about this term? See, minus 1 to the power 12, it is minus 1 will go. It is even. Now 3 to the power 12, you just write like this. How about this? 1 by root x to the power 12. You know that what is this? X to the power 6 it will be. How? So root x means x to the power half. And when you multiply by 12 outside index 2, 6 and 12, x to the power 6. This gets cancelled. This whole term is your t13th term. And you see it is independent of x. There is no x in this result. It is 1, 8, 5, 6, 4 only coefficient will be there. There will be no x. So, whenever you do t13, you have to do t12 plus 1. This is the logic here. So, this is the question on this this particular term. Now, let us find out. Now, we have to find out the middle term. How can the question be? You have to find out the middle term. So, let us take a question here. You have to find out a middle term. And the question is 2 by 3 x square minus 3 by 2 x. It is the power 20. Index is 20. You have to find out the middle term. What is the n? N is 20. Is it even or odd? It is even. We know that the expansion will give you n plus 1 terms. So it will be 21 terms in all. So what is the result? N by 2 plus 1. You just have to do n by 2 plus 1. It is 10 plus 1. So 11th term will be the middle term. The 11th term will be the middle term. N is even. When it is even, you get n by 2 plus 1. N is 20. Now, what is t11 term? You know t11 term is 10. T10 plus 1. So, what is t10 plus 1? So, what is n here? 20. So, ncr. What is r here? 10. So, r is 10. N is 20. So, you have 20c, 10, ncr. And 2 by 3 x squared to the power 20 minus 10. N minus r. 20 minus 10. So, let me write it as 10. And then minus 3 by 2x to the power r. That is 10. So, when you solve it, it will come as 20c10 x to the power 10. So, you will be able to solve it. This is the logic. So, basic thing is n you have to first find out. Even it is n by 2 plus 1. If it is odd, two terms will get, you will get n plus 1 by 2 and n plus 3 by 2. Do term. आपको मिलेंगे उसमें टू टर्म्स विल गेट सो दिस इज द मिडिल टर्म क्वेश्चन नाउ लेट अस गो टू अ क्वेश्चन व्हिच इज फाइंडिंग द कोएफिशिएंट फॉर अ गिवन इंडेक्स एक्सपोनेंट ऑफ द वेरिएबल नाउ दिस टाइप ऑफ क्वेश्चन लेट अस टेक वन मोर क्वेश्चन हियर सो लेट मी गिव यू एन एग्जांपल हियर नाउ वी हैव टू फाइंड आउट द कोएफिशिएंट वी हैव टू फाइंड आउट द कोएफिशिएंट ऑफ एक्स टू द पावर x plus 2y to the power 9. This is the binomial expansion. And you have to find out the coefficient of x to the power 6, y to the power 3. Whatever is in front of this number, this variable or this expression x to the power 6, y to the power 3 is going to be your coefficient. So, let us assume that it is some, it comes in some tr plus 1 term. So, what is tr plus 1? It is going to be ncr. What is n here? 9. This is n. So, 9cr. Now, x to the power n minus r. 9 minus r. And 2y. 2y to the power r. Now, 9cr. Now, just separate them. 2 to the power r is here. X to the power n minus 9 minus r. And y to the power r. And y to the power r. Now, this is rr plus 1 term, which is equal to x to the power 6, y to the power 3. You have to find out the coefficient of the term, x to the power 6, y to the power 3. So, equate it. When you equate it, you have to equate the power of x and y. You can see y to the power r is y to the power 3. X to the power 6 is x to the power 9 minus 2. So, equate it and 9 minus r will be equal to 6. R will be equal to 3. R will be equal to 3. See, y equal to r is y equal to 3, y to the power 3. So, what do you get? 9c3. Now, you put r equal to 3. 2 to the power 3. X to the power 6. Y to the power 6. Y to the power 3. So, 9c3 2 cube is the coefficient of this expression. When? Expansion. When we have x to the power 6 and y to the power 3. This is the coefficient of expansion. When you have x to the power 6, y to the power 3. This term coefficient is 672. This is the coefficient of this, x to the power 6, y to the power 3. So, this is how we find out the coefficient. You have binomial expansion. Now, we need to find out the term which is independent of the variable. We have to find out the term in the binomial expression which is independent of the variable. There is no variable, no x, no y. Right? So, how to do this? Let us take an example. Say you have 3x square minus 1 by 2x cube to the power 10. Now, we have to expand it and we have to find out that particular term which has no x. So, again, we'll assume that it is some tr term, means rth term. So, r plus tr plus 1 will be, tr plus 1 will be ncr. What is n here? 10. 10 cr and then we have 3x square to the power 10 minus r and minus 1 by 2x cubed to the power r. So now you have to see x, you know, you have to collect the power of x. So 3 to the power 10 minus r, now x to the power, multiply to this, 2 into 10 minus r, 20 minus 2r. So it will be x to the power 20 minus 2r. Now there is one more x in the denominator. So let us see it here, x to the power 2 into 10 minus r, and we have 1 by x cubed to the power r. So when you take it up, minus half to the power remains like this. So it will be 20 minus r, and then when you take minus 2r, when it goes up, it will be minus 3r. So it will be 20 minus 5r, x to the power 20 minus 5r. Now you have been told that you might want to find out the term which is independent of x, where there is no x, that is x to the power 0 is there. Independent of x, that means there is no x. So 20 minus 5r has to be equal to 0. So 20 equal to 5r, r will be equal to 20 by 5, that is 4. So r is 4. Now you have to find out the coefficient, you already have it. So t4 plus 1 you have to find out, r is 4, t4 plus 1 you have to find out, 10c4, 3 to the power 6, 10 minus 4 is 6, and minus half to the power 4. So we have just put r as 4 here. So what is the result? It will be 7, 6, 5, 4, 5 by 8. So this is independent of some variable. This is how we do it. Now there are other questions. Problem relating to the coefficients in a binomial expansion. Now we'll talk about 1 plus x to the power n, right? Now the r plus 1th term in the binomial expansion of, if r plus 1th term, coefficient of this r plus 1th term in the binomial expansion of 1 plus x to the power n. 1 plus x to the power n, what this will be? This will be ncr. Just remember this. And what is the coefficient of x to the power r in the binomial expansion of 1 plus x to the power n? It is ncr. Coefficient of x to the power r in the expansion of 1 minus x to the power n? It will be minus 1 to the power r, ncr. And coefficient of r plus 1th term in the expansion of 1 minus x to the power n? It will be minus 1 to the power r and ncr. Now these things, let me take a problem so that you understand what I am talking about. The question is, find a positive value of m for which the coefficient of x square in the expansion of 1 plus x to the power m is 6. The question is, we have 1 plus x to the power m. We have to find that value of m, positive value of m, for which the coefficient of x square in the expansion of 1 plus x to the power m is 6. Whenever we expand, wherever there is x square coming, the coefficient of x square should be 6. That is, the term should be 6x square. Now we know that when we have 1 plus x to the power n, the coefficient of x to the power r in 1 plus x to the power n is simply ncr. Is ncr, right? Since we have 1 plus x to the power m, so we'll take this as, it has to be, the coefficient has to be 6. The coefficient of x square in 1 plus x to the power m should be 6. So m, we will not take n here because m is the given. M1 plus x to the power m is there. So mc2 we are going to take, and this has to be 2, this has to be equal to 6. The coefficient has to be 6. So this is going to be m minus 1 by 2 or factorial 2 equal to 6. And we'll get m square minus m equal to 12. So m square minus m, and take 12 here, you will make the factors, it will be m minus 4 and m plus 3. M plus 3, you cannot take m plus 3 because it is going to give you negative value. M equal to 4, this is the result. So this kind of problems will be solved like this. That is, anywhere you have some 1 plus x to the power m term or 1 plus x to the power n term, then you are going to find out. Now there are problems based on consecutive terms or consecutive coefficients. These are the questions which are, you know, asked in NCRT also. 2-3 questions are there. So for example, you have, say, x plus a to the power n. So if we assume we have consecutive terms, so we'll take rth term then r plus 1th term, then r plus 2th term, that is tr, tr plus 1 and tr plus 2. Tr, tr plus 1 and tr plus 2. These are three terms and they are in certain ratio. They are always given in certain ratio. So what we will do? We will do tr plus 1 by tr, then we will do tr plus 2 by tr plus 1 and equate them. If you have tr minus 1, you can divide by tr minus 1 and tr plus 1 by tr. Right? So this is how we divide. Now let me take an example so that you understand what I am trying to say. So we have a question of NCERT. The coefficient of 3 consecutive terms in the expansion of 1 plus x to the power n are in this ratio 1:7:42. So we have to find out the n. What is n? So if you expand it, 3 consecutive term, 1 by 1 term, the ratio is given. The coefficient ratio is given. So these 3 consecutive terms, we assume first term to be the rth term, then r plus 1th term and r plus 2th term. This we assume. Okay. So what is the coefficient? What is the coefficient? See, when you have r, tr minus 1 you are talking about, because it will be tr minus 1 plus 1. R is r, tr minus 1 plus 1. So ncr minus 1 is the coefficient. How about tr plus 1? It will be simply ncr. We talk about ncr plus 1. So tr plus r plus 2 means r plus 1 plus 1. So you have to find out this is as ncr plus 1. So now you have to take the coefficient. 1:7 is there. So ncr by ncr r by ncr minus 1 is to ncr is to ncr plus 1. This is given as 1:7:42. So what do we do? First we'll take the first two and then we'll take the second two. So we will take ncr minus 1 by ncr is equal to 1/7. This is 1/7. We know ncr by ncr minus 1, we have already seen that. This is going to be n minus r plus 1 by n r by n minus r plus 1. We have already seen this in permutation combination. You can directly write it as r by n minus r plus 1. And this is going to be 1/7. So you will get an equation n minus 8r plus 1 equal to 0. Now take these two, the other two. So we are taking ncr plus 1 and ncr. So ncr plus ncr by ncr plus 1 is nothing but 7:42. 7/42. So what do you get here? You already know how to solve this. This is going to be r plus 1. R plus 1 by n minus r. And this is going to be equal to 1/6. 7/6 is 42. And you have equation n minus 7r minus 6 minus 6 minus 6 equal to 0. When you solve it, you are going to get r equal to 7 and n equal to 55. This is how you find out the n. So this is how we solve it. And now we are ready for the question. Thank you so much. Take care of yourself.